Hello guys and welcome back to another video. How are you doing today? This is BrightCode. So in today's video, but before we start, if this is your first time of watching my video or you are not yet subscribed, please go to that subscribe button, click it, turn on bell notification and like my video for more web tutorials like this. So today's video will be taking a look at how to create a settings page, just like a user profile settings page. Now what this does is that some website or many websites, what they do is that they have a settings page where you can change your information on your website, maybe your account setting, privacy settings, subscription and other things. So what you are going to create today, this is what we'll be creating, where you can change it. Maybe if you don't like this, or if you don't like your name, don't like your date of birth or gender, you can change it, email, anything. So this is what we'll be creating today. So right here, what I have here is that we have an input where maybe this is your name. You can change it to anything, if you change your gene, blah blah blah. You can put updates or your date of birth, which is birthday, female, male, or well, male, gender, transgender, anyone you want to put, your email and your password. And we also have payment info if you want to change your payment, MasterCard, Visa, and billing address, zip code, billing date, redeem card. After that, we also have others, which is payment, subscription info, privacy settings and account setting. So these are all created and designed. So if you want to learn how to do it, just follow my video right now, don't skip anything. Okay guys, this is what we'll be creating to this video. So if you want to learn it very well, just follow my video and you understand very much. Okay guys, let's get started on this.
Okay guys, the first thing we have here now is our editor and our live preview. So what we are going to do now, just create our tag, give the title of, what should we name it, user settings page. You can name it whatever you want. So we are going to use font or some jQuery. These are the two things we are going to use. We're also going to use JavaScript and some, just a little bit of jQuery or some part, where we are going to see it when we do it. So let's just do this, make it to style .css, and the other one should be font or some, should be an offline font or some. If you want, you can use the online own, that is by using the URL. You can get it on their website, which is fontawesome.com. So after that, we should link our jQuery, which is jQuery.js, and then just create a script that will be easier. Should create two actually, one for JavaScript and one for the jQuery, something like this. Okay, now let's move over to the HTML. HTML, we're going to have a container where we'll put everything in. After the container, we should have a left box, that is where the navigation will be, the navigation that which is the icons. After that, we should have a nav tag, and then add a link. The link should have a class of tab, and then let's just remove our href, or we should just remove it all, we don't need it now. So after that, we should have an onclick event, because you're going to click it. Onclick event should be tabs, that should be 0 first. After that, I think that is it. Then inside our a tag, our link tag, we should have an icon, i.far user, which is a user icon, and when you save it, it appears here. Okay, now let's just copy and paste it. Let's copy and paste it 4 more times. We are going to use 4 links, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, if you change it to 1, you understand what this or how we do this on click event. And we are going to, when we reach the JavaScript, or if you are watching all my other videos, you know what I will do with this link to, with this or click event. So after that, you should have an active class on the first one, because it's going to be the one that is active. After that, you should have over this, and this should have a credit card there, and the other one should have, that should be TV. Then the next one should be task, sorry, Next one should be tags, and the last one should be cog, which is settings. Cog, let's just use only one. And these are all what we need on the first side. Then after navigation, we are going to have a right bus. This is for the left side. If you see my introduction, that is for the left nav, the one that come out. Then after that, we are going to have our right bus. So dot right box. This is where every the information will be. So that is after the left bus, we put our right bus. And inside our left bus, we shall have a profile. So that is should be profile dot tab. Tab show. That's just what I want to name it. You can name it whatever you want. And header with a personal information. Then a h2. You want a h2. So what h2 carry now? Be full name. And then have an input where you can put your full name in case you want to change it. Then you should have a class of input too. Yes, class of input and a test, and then a value. Oh, sorry, value. Can name, let me say Jane Doe, that is what I want you to have. Jane Doe, you can change it whatever you want. Sorry, yeah, let's refresh. And this you can also do it for the other ones. So after that, you should have another H2. Right here, yeah, sorry. Is to copy and if it's after full name, it should be birthday. Give it a birthday. Since when you are entering, you should also have a birthday too. Like when you are registering, there should be a birthday, maybe a date of birth and all this thing. Maybe April 20, 1990, whatever. After that, you should have the next one, should be after birthday, should be gender. So in this gender now, what I want to do is that I'm going to use an input, but by default what you're supposed to use is a select option. That's what you're supposed to use, a select option, but due to time I'm just going to use an input. Later you can change it to a select option where you can select between a male and a female instead of typing it out. So if you want to still follow, you can still follow and do the same thing I'm doing, but please use a select option when you need on your website so that it will be easier for other people to follow and understand too. Then email address should have, that should be example@example.com, and just leave it like that. I don't add anything. So after the next thing, we should have a password. That should be password. If you want to change your password, password. And after password, so I'm just going to write just maybe BrightCode as password. And we're going to change the type. Password, so here, change to password. So after that, the last thing we should do on this side, we should be button.btn. That's what we want to do. And that should be update. That should update what you want to change. So guys, let's copy this. This is for the first side. Here's the profile. Copy and paste. And the next one should be payment. Payment, after payment it should be payment info. Should change it to payment info. That's for payment info, it should be payment method, not payment. What method do you want to use according to the person who used the info? MasterCard, and sorry, MasterCard. Then you can just put any number. For it must be 16 digit, and then maybe it's just some. I hope that's 16 digit. After the payment info, it should be billing address, where you want it, your billing address. Then that should be billing address. I should just put maybe, I don't know, 1234 at some street in a town. Can just put your billing address, that just doesn't matter. For now, just follow me. We are just looking at how to do it. We are not exactly doing it for anybody or anything. So zip code. Which zip code should I put? Maybe 419 and 911. Call 911. See, then the billing date. sorry, billing date. Let's just type random billing date. What date should we put? Let me say January 20, 2017. That should be the billing date. Then just this one, I just put it for fun here. Redeem gift or redeem card, or sorry, let's just put it to redeem a card. You can type the card you want to redeem. If you have a code or a coupon, you can just enter it here. Maybe enter gift code. Enter gift code, that is it. Then the button should just be like that. Don't touch anything. So after everything, let me check payment. Then we should move down to what is that, is subscription. There are some cases where I did not put full thing, that is full info. Instead, I'm just going to use a paragraph instead of the input. I'll just change the input to paragraph, since not all everything you may change. Maybe like this subscription now, let me say payment date, you not change it. That is the day you pay me, so we're not, that is the day you paid something, so we're not going to change it. Instead, we're going to leave it here. That is something you cannot change on your user profile page or something like that. So instead, you're going to stay there. Payment date, when you paid something, May 12, 2019, 2019 or such. Wow, then not birthday, change it to next charge. This is something that they will charge you for, so you cannot change it. That's why I'm removing all this input, like I've mentioned. So next charge, how many dollars and how many cents? It should be, I'm just put 80.5. is that correct? 80.56. then add the span. Am I correct? Add the span of including taxes too. Include tax. Okay, then the next one should be plan. Your next plan, that should be paragraph. Or your plan, the plan you use is limited plan. Let's just put it a limited plan. Then secondly or thirdly or whatever, monthly total, what you got either monthly or anything, you can add it here. Sorry, my mouse is disturbing. Paragraph. So the monthly total, I'm just going to put maybe 107.99 per month. Like I said, it's monthly total. Then, lastly, that should be the last. So after that, I'm just going to remove this. And then, yes, I'm just going to leave the update there. So let me copy this since almost from here. Out now, we are not going to be using any input. So the next one should be privacy. Ctrl V. Instead of subscription, it should be privacy. Inside privacy, we have sweet. Before I continue, subscription info. That should be what is here. Subscription. Hope I got it right. Subscription info. Then this other one should be privacy setting. That is to set your privacy. Privacy settings, the first should be manage email notification. Let's just leave it for short notification. Then should remove. So I don't have anything to put here, like I cannot think of something to put here, so just I'm just going to leave it empty. But if you have anything to put, you can just add it here. Maybe manage privacy settings. After that, just remove this. Just remove all this. Then the next one, instead of plan, is double view terms of use. I could have using a button right here, but just don't have that time to do so. Personalize add experience. And then lastly, what am I doing? personalize, add experience, that should be Control X, Control V. This should be capitalized. First letter, personalize, then this should be removed. Okie dokie. Maybe I should add one more. Two. Control C, Control V, and the one more should be protect your account from thieves. Protect. Protect account. Then this paragraph and the button, like always. So lastly, I hope this is the last. Lastly, another one that should be settings, just settings. Settings, and inside the setting we have account setting instead of privacy setting. Then the first one should be a sync watch list to my stuff, or just sync watch list. Sync watch list, watch list. I hope I got it right. Then after that, hold your subscription. Hold sub. Subscription. The next should be, let me just say, cancel subscription. In these places, we are going to do the best thing to use our buttons instead of this paragraph. Buttons are the best things to use. So I'm just not going to use it right now. Sorry about that. So cancel subscription. After cancel subscription, your devices. What this does is the devices you have used on this account, like your Samsung, iPhone, different devices, is where they are going to appear. And then referrals. Referrals. Just that's it for the HTML. Okay, guys, we are done for the HTML. And why is this taking long to load? Please don't do anything stupid. After that, guys, I'm thinking we should move over to the. Which now I'm thinking we should move over to the style of CSS. Oh, seems like I cancel this. Waiting. Please, 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 please be fast, be fast, be fast, be fast. Okay. There it is. This is everything. Account settings, privacy settings, subscription info, and now let's make it look beautiful as always using our CSS. So moving over to our CSS, which is right here, we have our font which we are going to be using, and then body. We are going to be using a gradient on the body, so that should be background. Background should be linear gradient, linear gradient, and linear gradient is moving to right. Should move to the right, and that should be hex value 2ED573, and that is light green right here. That is light green. And lastly, F9, what is F9? F9 CA24. Confirm that is it right there. I got these colors from Flat UI Colors. Can check the website in the description below. So overflow X hidden. After that, body, we should move over to container. Sorry for the flashes, but for now it seems like instead of the having too much flashy, let's just move this one a little bit. Let's see, now it's not doing that much. So container, we should have our background should be white. Background should be white, it should have a width of 540 pixels. Width 540 pixels, height 450 pixels, and then margin 0 or 2. After that, sharp position relative, and then margin top should be 10%. That is for it to go down. Then should have a box shadow of 2 pixels, 5 pixels, 20 pixels, RGB should be, let me just say 0.0.0.5. Should this be enough? Or let me just use some other color, which is 119 and 119.5. Yeah, this is a little bit lighter. Then after that, choose our left box, which is our navigations, our left navigations. So which is left box. Our left box should float left. So floating left top minus 5%. Then after top minus 5%, we have left 5% and a position absolute right there. Let's make something so that it'll be easier to see. Right box display none. So let's focus on this one. Let's see if this is still disturbing. And then after that, shall be width. It seems it's still disturbing us. 15%. So let's just cancel it for now. Width should be 15%, or should I say, yeah, 15%. Any height, I want 10%. After that, we should have a background. Background should be a little bit blue, greenish. Should be 2E, D5, and a 7.3. Correct. After that, the box shadow. Give it a box shadow of lighter. Let's just copy this first. Ctrl C. Ctrl V. So instead, you have 3 and a 3 and a 10. Okay. After that, you should have a border too to make it more good. Border should be 0.1 EM solid white. Now that looks more good. And now the link. Sorry, navigation the nav A. That should be list type. No, since it doesn't have any list, but let's just keep it that way. Let's make it go higher. List type none. And the padding should be 35 pixels. Padding should be 35 pixels. And also color should be white. Color should be white. Then font size should be 1.1 em. Then display block should have a display block, and should also have a transition just in case of hover effects or any other effect that takes place. Ease in out. Now how do you see it? Now this is more like it. So after the transition, now the hover effect, which is now a dot hover, and the color when it is hover should be more like 10 AC 84. So if I hover over it, this is the color I should give. And you should have cursor pointer, and then transform. Let's make it a little bit bigger, which is scale 1.2, so that when you hover over it, it should be bigger. Maybe you can see it clear. See, it is a little bit bigger. So after that, we should have our first child. Should move it, push it back a little bit. Our first child. First child should be margin top. That should be 7. Okay. Now it is more balanced. So this case, now what we are going to do is the active. Before we forget, no, don't worry. Here, this is the active one, which is the first one. So let's just put, instead of anything, let's just put active, because that's the only one we give anything active. But when we are doing it on the website, you should have a nav. Let's just follow it. Let's just do nav a dot active. When it is active, you should have a color of this. Just exactly this right here. Okay. So I think that should be it. Then now we should move over to our right box. Good. No more displaying none. So we don't have much to do with CSS. We should just have width 60%, which should be 60%. Margin left 27%. Now after our right box, then the tab. Oh, once with the tab should have a transition. 0.5 seconds is in, and a width of 80. %. So tab, I believe these are the first tab, or should I just make it, okay, the other tab is tab show, if I'm right, tab show, maybe that should work. Let's see how it is. Then after that we should have over to our H or H1, should have a font family of Montserrat. Did I get that right? Okay, hold on guys. Sans serif. Then after Montserrat, so we should have a color. Sorry about that. Should have the color of A7ED. 7ED386. Now that's it. Any font size? Should have a font size of 1.2. RAM. Font size 1.2 RAM. And then margin top should be 40 pixels. After that, margin bottom 35 pixels. Okay, this is too small. No, I think that is okay. And our H2 after that. Our H2 should have a color of light gray. Light gray and a font family. Should have a font family of Roboto. Good. Roboto sans serif. Text transform. Uppercase. And then font size 8 pixels. Though it is a little bit smaller, but you see it when it is done. Letter spacing should be 1 pixels. 1 pixels margin left. Margin left should be 2 pixels. And then margin top should be 10 pixels. Okie dokie. Then after that, we should over to our input and our paragraphs. Now what we want them to do, should have a border 0. Shouldn't have any border. And the border button should be 1 pixels. 1 pixel solid. That should be 3 FB. 3 FB CC. 6A8. Okay. And a width of 80 pixels. And font family of Montserrat. Montserrat sans serif. Now that's more like it. Font size should be 0.7 em, a little bit smaller. And then padding should be 7 pixels and 0 pixels. After that, show over top, should have a color of a little bit green, 0 7 0 7 0 7. Maybe dark gray and no outlines. Okay guys, after that you should have a span, all the span too. Though you are not much span, maybe only one span, which is this include taxes that is there. So include taxes, which is span, font size should be 0.7 with a color 777. Okay guys, then after that bit button, we should have our button to be font family. That should be Roboto. Sans serif. Just dot btn. And text transform. Uppercase. And then font size should be 15 pixels. And after that, you should have a border. No border. We don't want any border. We want colors should be light gray. Our color should be white, a whiter color with a background. Background should be 7ED386. This is an padding 7 pixels, 15 pixels. This is box shadow 0 pixels, 2 pixels, and 4 pixels, 0 pixels. RGB point 2, just a little bit lighter above shadow, cursor pointer, and then margin top should be 15 pixels. Okay guys, we are almost getting somewhere, or let's say we are almost done with it. Now just last three things we just need to put together. Auto privacy h2, privacy h2 should margin top. Oh, this are okay, all these are all right. So then let's just leave this as it is. Then tap show. Now in using our, we are going to use our JavaScript right now, so we should put it at display none. Now we are going to use our JavaScript in order to enable it to be displayed. For that we should have our good. Now first things, we are going to use our JavaScript. Though you might understand this if you are watching my other videos, just to make it more pretty. It's always good to have a prettier extension just in case your code is like spaghetti code. So first things, we have a cost. Tab it here, which is equal to document.query selector all dot tab. Just copy this, which is all this tab. This is what it means. And the next one should be just tab, and that should be tab show, which is all what we put at displayed none. Okay, and then after that we should have our function. Create a function, create a function and name it tabs, then give it a parameter of index, and then add a for each loop on it, so it should loop through each tabs. After looping through each tab, then give it a function too, and then another parameter of node. So that now make our node to be displaced, since our node is like the tab, which is this tab. It's not replacing the tab. node.style.display, display, it should be equal to none. After that you should then tab panel index should be dot style dot display block. So let me just put it as block, and then let's call the function outside it. So that should be tabs, the first one is 0. Good, now this is it, as you can see right here. Now everything is okay, but this privacy setting is just at the top. But before we do that, we should just go back to our last one, which is, in order to make this, see when we click this, the first one is still with the color. So once we click on any of this, it should be active. The one that we click should be active. So in order to do that, we are going to be using jQuery. So after that, we should have, when we click on each tab, tab.click, then call a function. And the tab that we click, what this means now, this thing is, when we click on this tab, that is the tab that is clicked, which is this tab that we clicked. We want it to add a class to it. Dot add class, active to the tab that we clicked. And in order for this to work, you also have to display all, add this query selector all. So if you click any, since there are more than one, if you click on any of these, so add active to it. And when you do this, when you click on this, she's added active. So we want to let the other one move out when you have added it. So what you're going to do is that each siblings dot remove, siblings dot remove class active too. Now when you click on it, you can see right here, now this is it. So for our style.css, our h1, what's on to this margin top 40 pixels. I don't know why it's not working, or did I do something wrong? So you can check it out and maybe check if there's something wrong or something that I did not do when I was checking it, or maybe right boss, or should I just put padding top 40 pixels? No, that should be 20 pixels or 10 pixels or 5 pixels. Is this alright? Okay guys, now this is it, but this is very small. Okay, I think I've seen where the problem is. Settings, privacy, dot tab show. This, where is it, dot tab show? Let me just check out something very quick. Let me just say profile first, which is this profile. But first things first, let me just move this and then add instead of this profile. I think it is working. Why is it like this? Tab show with 80%. Did I do a mistake? Alright guys, now this is it. Position, I forgot to put a position of absolute on the tab show. So this is what we just created guys. I hope you like it, and if you do, please subscribe to my video so that will help me out. Thank you very much guys, and I hope to see you again very soon.